Hello, and welcome back to Zach and Wiki. So, I didn't start playing the level, but my capture card does this weird thing where sometimes the noise messes up, or the audio messes up, and I thought it was doing that. I'm not convinced it was, but either way, I stopped recording and I couldn't exactly start again. So, there'll be a big skip thing over the opening cutscenes of the next level, but after that, you'll see that the skip goes away. So I didn't actually play anything, I just quit the second I could. So yeah, we're starting off with Maddie again. Another one of those things. Ah, so it's called Hexaleg. Interesting. Go there. So yeah, I think my capture card was fine, but I guess I'm paranoid. Oh well. This time, we get to finally visit Treasure Island. And I just skipped through the cutscene, trying not to look at it, so get to see it for the first time in a while still. Yeah, there's the skip button. Oh well. Afraid not. Whoa. Oh. Sorry, Johnny. Stole your line. Oh boy. Whoa. Oof. Yeah. I hope Rose wasn't renting that, or else, she's gonna be on the same list as us. Well, they all survived unscathed, somehow.
Yeah.
Steal a ship, something like that. Oh, yeah. How did you survive? Seriously. wait a minute. Take old Johnny safely away. Hold on a minute. Dude! What I don't understand is how he got from there to where we end up finding him. I don't know. There's really no way he should have been able to do that running in that direction, but whatever. I guess maybe. Yeah, let's grab it. Oh no. Ah, we've all gone negative. Someone develop the film. Oh, it's just you. A shining white smile? Oh no, no! Hey! Oh no, it's frost breath all over again. Uh-oh. Wait, they get resurrected with swords in their hands? Wow. Yeah. A lot of questions about what happened between them. You can keep forgetting about us. It's cool. Uh-oh. Is there room service? No room service. Do we at least get breakfast? Coins. Sadly, you can't collect any of the coins that are just constantly going down that waterfall. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the level of all levels. The level that I would definitely say is the single most elaborate, complicated, and long level in the entire game. Like, just the longest level. So, time for the zoom out of all zoom outs. Ooh, a crown. An anchor, that looks rather painful. Leads up to the legendary ship. You've got something that looks very much like a sword hilt. A little ship floating off there. We've got Barbaros down here. Hey! Meanie. We've got a pit of spikes right underneath of our rooms. Probably don't want to pull on those chains then. We've got that weird thing. Red gem. A skull that's got a sparkly eye, a weird eye thing, multiple jars, a guard making his rounds, rope, another eye thing, a pot, again, a jar, whatever, another gem, a flag, another guard making his rounds, and he's gonna go, like, up there and around and just stay on that circuit. We've got another jar. We've got a gem, a big rock, a rope for no real reason, a sword. We've got a boat that seems to have quite a bit of treasure on it. As well as another... Well, no, I already pointed that out. We've got the last bone lick of the game, and the only one to have blue hair, I believe. A frog that is asleep for the moment. A torch that's not lit, what looks like a tripwire, a totem spot, a golden sword, which is useless, don't use golden swords, a giant barrel, another guard who's loading stuff on that elevator that goes way up, room full of treasure, and then we've got that guard which makes his rounds, or who makes his rounds, like, I think he goes down, and then around. So yeah, there is a lot to this level. And this is the only other level, I think, other than Frost Breath, where we don't have Leaky. Alright, Zach, hope you enjoyed your chocolate bar. All levers must be pulled, and all chains must also be pulled. Give you a nice camera pan and just click on that. Uses his telekinesis powers to pull it toward him. Okay. He's coming. But I can show this off. I get points for this anyway. So if you don't want the guards to see you, you can just grab one of these, and the guards aren't very bright. Sorry if I was sniffing there. And yeah, these cool little panels control gravity. Good thing he can't hear Zach. He doesn't seem to have ears, but whatever. Oops, no, not what I meant to do. We want to grab this. There are lots and lots of sparkly things. We'll come back later with Wiki. I don't think I'm going to try and do a absolutely perfect run of this place, because that would require doing stuff that would give you special treasure, but we're not getting special treasure now, so whatever. I'll do it later, I'm sure. Ride this up, but Rude.
Yeah.
These guys, keep a watch out. So yeah, for instance, this guard here, if I remember correctly, over here, there's this crown, and you bring it here, and you drop it on his head through this hole, and then you drop a jar on him to defeat him. If you want to get a special treasure, but I don't care about the special treasure right now. So, just hold the Wii remote sideways and wait. See if I can get the timing right on this. Now. Perfect. Sorry. Okay. So that takes care of him, which is convenient. Next, grab this. Avoid this eye guy. What he will do is knock you right back down in your cell and make you come all the way up here again. So just don't walk in front of him when he's open. Luckily, he seems to be pretty drowsy. Then we stand on this, and this guy pours out pure gold dust. Let's take some home. Gold flakes. Yes, please. Right now, if you drop the... Man, there are a lot of frame rate drops. Right now, if you drop this, all of the gold flakes will just immediately spill out, so don't, unless you want to have to go refill it. And I'd recommend leaving this flagpole in place because it gives you a nice indication of which way the wind is blowing. And what we want to do... Oh, no, no, no. What we want to do is wait till the wind is blowing away from us. And really, you just have to wait. And wait. So, we're getting pretty close to the end of the playthrough. I mean, the next level is the last one of the game. Then there'll be the after game, but... Hey, there we go. Tilt it, pour, and... Short him out. Yeah, sorry. See, for that, some reason that doesn't empty this thing, but yeah, there you go. Yeah, sorry if I'm making more noises into the camera. My nose is bothering me. Winter. No, no, no. Out of the way. Okay. Shake this. Don't know if you could hear that. Some funny noises come out of the Wii remote there. And we get a lighter, which also seems to be made out of gold. But we can't actually do anything with that right now. So, leave that for later. Less backtracking if we grab this. There we go. The flag mysteriously disappears. Kind of like the mast on the pirate ship when you think about it. What? You're telling me this whole time I've played this level, I could have dropped something on him from here? Okay. Huh. I guess. I mean, that's what it looks like. Who knew? Eh, we could go talk with him right now, but it won't really do anything. Eh, why not? Hey. I busted out. I did. It's pretty great. Well, you can just pull on that chain. It'll get you right out. I wouldn't recommend that, though. Okay. So, that doesn't let you carry double-handed items. That is pretty cool. That doesn't let you carry double-handed items, I don't think. But single-handed items, like this pole, work just fine. Snake in there. You get points if you hide from them. Eh. Not that important. Sword. Come on. Grab it. Yeah, if that guy sees you, he'll just go straight after you. So this is cool, albeit a little bit tricky to pull off. Most important thing to remember is you gotta hold the Wii Remote sideways, not so that the A button is facing you, but so that the side is... Yeah, see, like, how they're holding it there. The B button is to the right. And then... No, I didn't do that. What? I totally swung it there. I'm swinging the thing! Oh! Ah! I don't know what was wrong. I was totally swinging the Wii Remote there. Well, I'm not redeeming all that. Yeah, like I'd shake it and it totally wasn't responding correctly. No. What? You... What? Okay, that really it makes absolutely no sense, but okay. I really don't want that guy to come, though. Come on, elevator, hurry. Okay. Huh, that is a really weird spot to put me. Okay, well, that's still out. This guy's still gone. Wait. Nope, the lighter's still there. Okay. It just put me in a weird spot. Okay. Rematch. So the trick is to not die when he swings from the side. When he swings up, swing at him. When he swings from the side, block him. Finally! Man, that was horrible. I do not like that mechanic at all. I mean, seriously, it is just, it's clumsy, it's unresponsive. I did not remember it being that bad, but it really is. I'm glad you only have to do it one more time. Unless you mess something up, which is easy to do. Anyway, we cut that. Oh yeah, you can get a cool little view from up here. Oh, sparkly spot. Anyway. There's the ship. Wonder what view you get from over here. Right, okay. Okay, there. Come on, there. Zach, that's all along one path. Seriously. Come on. It really does not like these corners, does it? This, the AI or whatever. Okay. next thing to do. This is actually a special treasure chest, but it's also just kind of cool if you can pull it off. Is... This is a bad time to do that. I'll get to it in a minute. Hopefully he'll be in a better position. Alright. Oh. Drat. Actually, I need that balancing pole. And I might as well just go ahead and do the thing at the rock. I don't know. Come on. Don't know why the frame rate is dropping so much. Okay, he's gonna come back along, and when he starts going down there, that's when I'm gonna pick up that rock and drop it on him if I can get it to work right. Good for points, good for taking out another pirate without having to do more sword fighting, and gives you a special treasure. Okay. Just shake the Wii Remote side to side. And... got him! Nice. That is... you do have to drop that rock, by the way. So, it's best to just go ahead and take him out. Okay, now. Here is a different little thing that they only use here. It's balancing. You just gotta... hold it sideways and tilt it to counteract Zack's movement, and he automatically moves forward and complains. He will fall if you mess this up. Whoa! Whoa! Like that! Oh, come on! I don't mess that up. I just totally stopped paying attention to the screen for a minute. Once again, I'm not bad at the level, but as soon as I start recording the level, oh well. Mild inconvenience. Let's try this again, though not for full points. This time, I'm gonna be quiet and pay attention to the screen. No, no, no. This is actually really responsive to you tilting the Wii Remote. There. Yeah, half points. Oh well. Don't need this anymore. So here we've got a gold sword. Just like that one that we saw way over there. There. These are useless. I believe if you try and use them in a battle, they just immediately get cut straight through because they're gold, and gold is a soft metal. So yeah, don't use that. We've got a treasure bell. And that will be useful later on. And we have a treasure crown. Or just crown. Which really isn't useful at all. Since we're not getting the special treasure. Alright, now. You can fan this slowly. And you can still beat the level, I think. But if you want to get the special treasure, you just want to fan super fast here. And you also... I think it gives you more points. So, fan fast. Don't let up. Reason being, well, one thing, it just gets them all down there, so that's nice and quick. And two, you can't actually carry that crown up this rope, or Well, that, yeah, you can't carry it anywhere from here, so you have to make it fall down there if you want to be able to get it all the way up there using the elevator later. So, yeah. Okay. Probably would be good to grab that sword. And this is a straight drop, Zach. Come on. There we go. Alright, we'll need that later. Right now, we need the gravel. And we want to carry it up here. So you noticed earlier, I would assume that this view lets us look down at the snake, but when we have this, we can toss it down at the snake, and we can do this as many times as we want, but basically, the key is, okay, I don't know why it wasn't responding there. The key is, move it a little bit to the right, because the wind is pushing to the left, and check it. Boom. Alright. Now the snake is knocked out and won't resist us trying to pick up the jar. So we can grab it. And do this. You could do this in a different order, I imagine. But I honestly don't know. It would give you the same result. The cutscene just might look a little different. I don't know. Man, it's like the one level where Wiki isn't there. They just give you non-stop sparkly spots. Just to taunt you. And a bone lick, of course. Okay, so man, this is flying by. Actually, I need that lighter. From earlier. Ah, this level just chugs. Should come up soon. Here we are. Yeah. Unauthorized, whatever. Grab the lighter. Climb down the rope. And now we head back down there. Be quicker, I think, just to stay up here. Alright, I'd love to just light this first, but I don't think it'll let me. Yeah, as soon as you get within range, this happens. Telekinesis. It's pretty cool. You could, like, help. That's okay. Really. I'm playing a video game. I'm pretty entertained. Luckily, this guy will never fight you. I don't know if it's just because that gold sword is there or what, but you actually have to walk up to him, which is why I left the sword down here. But anyway. Alright, what we want to do is, so, it doesn't really give you an instruction manual on how to do this. You flick the Wiimote back, or I guess just flick it, and then you push down on the D-pad. And then you tilt it. Until There we go. The fire wakes up the frog. You could probably do this first, but anyway. Frog comes up here. Ah! Snake! Jumps down these mysteriously floating pieces of wood. Okay, we don't need the lighter now. What we do need is that treasure bell. So it might look a lot like Wiggy, but it doesn't do anything. You can't even ring it. Shaking the Wii remote here now, it doesn't do anything. But we need it. I don't think it matters too much where it is. Just maybe somewhere around here. No, a bit closer than that. Yeah, I think that'll do. I don't want to take any chances. I'm probably just overthinking this, but yeah. Almost looks like it's floating. The shadow definitely doesn't match it. Whatever. And then this is the only other bout of required sword fighting. So I think you lose points for every unnecessary hit. I swung it. Well, it was better than last time at least. Alright, and we don't actually need the sword. So if we just walk in a bit further. So Barbaros will just keep spawning more of his crew members infinitely. But this time there's a frog nearby, and we know what frogs do. Things get pretty fast here. And then gotta grab the tripwire. And now. Perfect. Yeah. And he would ordinarily grab Wiki and turn us into a totem, but yeah, no, we're not going to be civil about this. Bye-bye. Your posture still stinks. Hey, buddy. Aww. What? No, of course not. Alright, so yeah, a lot going on there, but basically, just make sure he grabs this treasure bell instead of Wiki, because ordinarily he'd turn you into a totem. And bring Wiki at him. Let's start out by turning him into a totem. Hench mummy totem. And put him over here. Thank you, game, but no need to reward me for that. Come up here. Turn him into a slither gripper. Wait a minute. There isn't a sparkly spot up here, is there? Okay. Climb back down. Don't need the slither gripper yet because bone lick time. Last one of the game. probably the hardest, I can't remember. And no bonus points for this one, I think, because it's going to be pretty obvious what the song is. So, here we go. Oh, come on. Oh, there's no way. This is horrible. I'm not even trying anymore. Well, in case you couldn't tell, as you might very well not have been able to, because that was absolutely horrendous, that was the second Wiki theme. Or at least it was supposed to be. Kinda got distracted. There is a lot of sound coming out of the Wii remote this time around. Kind of a shame you can't hear it. Maybe you can, I don't know. Anyway, let's give this a try and see if I can do, you know, even a tiny bit better. Yeah, second attempt. Still not the best, but passable. And for that we get... Treasure Map 7. For once, we get them in numerical order. Sweet. And that's that. Last Bone Lick. Kinda hard to believe. I may not really seem like I should be giving any tips on how to do those. But, if I had to, I'd say that for the sections with the zigzaggy lines, I'm holding the Wii remote upright and I'm just shaking it back and forth really quickly and just making sure it keeps moving. Other than that, I think it's just the timing that's messing me up. And of course, hey, Johnny.
Hey.
Yeah, actually, that is a pretty good idea.
Hey.
Of course. Anyway, need to grab that Slither the Gripper. Eh, gotta grab it, just cause. Okay. So the gripper. Any sparkly spots? Nope. Pull this down. And then the elevator will just go as soon as you step on it. Hello! So many coins! Ah, my favorite thing. We are going to get rich off this level. Okay, there were sparkly spots over here. Holy cow! Whoa! Whoa! And we haven't even gotten them all yet. Man. This is awesome. Okay. Come up here. There was one up here, I believe. The coins obey the normal laws of gravity, then. Who knew? Hey, we made it there before it despawned. Sweet. Alright. Come back up here. Yeah, I didn't know that the coin would obey gravity. Like, normal gravity. Sparkly spot over here. Cool. Sorry, got distracted. Thought I saw another one. I didn't know. Waited to collect these things until I wiki just because it makes collecting the coins a whole lot quicker. Come over here. What? I keep seeing something that looks like it's sparkling. Funny, I thought I remember there being one over here. Oh well, guess not. Alright, is that all the ones we missed? There's a jewel in there. I think that thing had a sparkly thing. So there's some stuff up there. Alright, I think the only way to get back up there is to go back and ride that elevator again, so let's do that. Guess I didn't need to bring the Slither Gripper with me after all, but oh well. Climb on the elevator. Right up. Get knocked back. Pick up the glitched out Slither Gripper. Collect more coins. Oh my goodness. $1,420. Oh my goodness. I'm pretty sure there aren't actually any coins in those. Those were spare ammunition in case you'd missed this guy. Okay. More coins. Even more coins. They don't call it Treasure Island for nothing. Sorry, I literally couldn't exit out of that. And those two little coins are not worth accidentally sitting through that again, so... Okay, unless there were any down here... Nah, I don't see any. I think we got all the sparkly spots. Looks like it. Sweet. Now. Again, I did. Alright. Well, you could... I don't know what would happen if you tried just pulling the chain, but that'd be really, really mean. Basically, what you want to do is... Turn them all into totems. This is the one time you get to do that with Rose in the game. And... Conveniently, those spikes go down in a slope, leading to an opening that's also a slope, and... Boom. Can't pull your own chain. And for some reason, that chain stays down, unlike ours. Okay, and then we head on back down. Don't actually need the Slither Gripper for anything at this point, I don't think, but... this way, Zach. Okay... No, I didn't mean to do that. Doesn't matter. Add to the item count. The one time you can pick this up in the entire game, so, do. Rose Totem. Aww, it's so cute. Is there any way to view it so that it's, like, not in an angle? I like how it's even got the hat and everything. Extremely cute. Anyway. Turn these guys back, and... Yes, I did. Wow, you lost an awful lot of memory from turning into a totem. I wonder if memory loss like that happens with everyone. It's weird that they feel the need to make it sound like... Sorry. To make it sound like you haven't seen him, because you have. I don't know.
Good job.
Thank you. Right there, I think.
Yeah.
Just not gonna question that. Okay. Color me confused. Anyway, now we just do this. The goons lift the barrel. I love how she's just taking pride in the fact that they work hard. I don't know. Something about it is just goofy. They're squishy. And man, they can jump high. Anyway. We pull that down. Cutscene triggers. Zach climbs in. Wiki really doesn't seem to care. Oh, no, he actually did join us. The all-seeing eye does not see, and that is the level. Holy cow. I just looked at how long this episode is. Well, I knew it was a long level, but I didn't realize it was like 48 minutes long. That is a nice ship. Indeed we did. Oh, what the heck would the rest of the way be? This is the legendary ship. You're a new ship. Who did all the work here? Well, I can't say I share Winky's sentiment, but, alright. Stage cleared. One level left, and then we are at the end of the game, on to the after game. Lots of items. Rising Pirate Hero. Nice picture. All right. Well, this is officially my longest video to date. So I am just going to start off the next episode with Maddie. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time when we take care of the final level of the game. Bye.